Wow, look at all these people here. This place is packed. I'm asking myself, where were all of you when my movie came out last January? Can't believe it. But anyway, let me just tell you, first I want to congratulate all the inductees to the WWE Hall of Fame. Of course, I have the great pleasure of introducing Bruno Sammartino. I met him in the late 60s when I was competing in the Mr. Olympia contest, and there was Bruno Sammartino amongst the judges. He was judging the Mr. Olympia competition. I looked at my friend and I said, look at this guy. Look how huge he is. Huge neck, the trapezius was sticking out. Deltoids like cannonballs. The chest was like a fortress. Huge lats. The thighs were coming out of his pants. And I'm looking at it and I said, there is something wrong here in America. I just came from Europe. I said, there's something wrong in America. I said that the judges look bigger than us athletes up here on stage. What's going on here? I mean, it's fantastic. And then I was so excited seeing this guy. And my friend said, this is the world's greatest wrestler. And I was so honored that he was judging the Mr. Olympia competition. So after the judging, the pre-judging was over, I went over to him and I had a great, great conversation. And he's such a nice and kind human being. And I'm so proud of him because he's such a great immigrant. I mean, what a great immigrant story. To come over here from Italy, I mean, when he was a kid, he had to run away from the Nazis. And he almost died several times, and his mother brought him back. And then he moved over here to Pittsburgh. And there he was bullied around. He was bullied around because he had an accent and because he was scrawny. But then he started lifting weights, and then he started wrestling, and he started getting bigger and better. And then all of a sudden, all the bullies disappeared. And then he continued and he became the world champion in wrestling. And he became this great inspiration. Not only did he wrestle for these millions of people, but he brought so much great inspiration to so many millions of children and got them turned on into working out and staying away from alcohol and from drugs and from gangs and all this crazy stuff and to get involved in sports and in wrestling. So he has made such great contributions to this country. This is why I'm so excited here. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the great wrestler, the great champion, the great Bruno Sammartino.
In 2013, Little Caesars created a new deep dish pizza with a crust so deep and perfectly crispy on the outside that three astroscientists shrunk themselves down in an attempt to understand it.
That's some deep crust!
Little Caesars, home of the $5 hot and ready pizza, proudly introduces the new deep, deep dish pizza with eight thick, crispy corner slices hot and ready every day for just $8.
Pizza, pizza.
Don't scratch it, kid.
My sweet potato tots are so much fun, you can kind of play with them. I could never do that when I was a kid. My mom wouldn't let me.
Call her.
Hello, Mom? Absolutely. I have to go home. I'm grounded.
Get popping with spicy jumbo popcorn chicken and sweet potato tots. This is how you Sonic.
How does your small business stay top of mind with customers? From deals that bring them in with an offer to social media promotions that turn fans into customers, to events that engage and create buzz, to emails that keep loyal customers coming back. Our easy-to-use tools will keep you in front of your customers. See what's right for you at constantcontact.com/try.
Right now at Long John Silver's, catch incredible savings with $4 at a meal. Buy one meal regular price, get each additional meal for just $4. Your favorite meals at an incredible price. The more you buy, the more you save. Catch $4 at a meal only at Long John Silver's.
Dad, you're not getting my bites.
Hello? Oh, hey, Brian.
Brian?
Yeah, she's here.
I'll take it in my room.
That Brian?
No, telemarketer. Oh.
KFC Bites. Freshly hand-breaded big bites of 100% breast meat. Now with our famous hot gravy. Try a six-bite combo for just $3.99. Today tastes so good.
You are going to be Mrs. Marlo Lassiter.
Tomorrow, it's the first psych wedding.
You're doing all your wedding planning in one day?
I've got one speed, and it is full throttle.
But Lassie's big day?
It's not going to be a bachelor party.
What? Turns into one crazy night.
Surprise! What the hell?
Welcome to your bachelor party.
Let's do this.
Yeah! An all-new episode of Psych, tomorrow at 10 on USA. Characters welcome.
In the delicate art of crime scene investigation, these pros always handle with care.
Oh, that's nasty.
CSI, coming up next on USA. Characters welcome.
It's the greatest event in entertainment. Now, WWE is giving away 30 trips to WrestleMania at Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. Text MANIA30 to 59907 or enter online at wwe.com/winmania. 30 extraordinary WrestleMania trips.
The greatest entertainment extravaganza of all time.
Make sure one of them is yours. Go to wwe.com to learn more.
To be inducted into an Hall of Fame, of course, it's extremely special. But to happen here in Madison Square Garden, that is... I have a quiet history in this building, and I'd like to share a little bit of it with you. For one thing, I'm extremely proud that I headlined Madison Square Garden more time than anyone in the history of Madison Square Garden. I'm very proud of that. I can hardly believe it when I tell you this, that it was 50 years ago that I became the Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion in Madison Square Garden, 50 years ago. How many of you were even born yet then? It's a long, long time ago. But I could tell you many other great events that happened in the Garden. But I must tell you how grateful I am of what the Garden did for me. Because, you know, in this country, in every city, we have beautiful arenas everywhere. And they may be bigger than the Garden even, or maybe even, I haven't been around because I've been retired a long time, maybe even nicer looking, I don't know. But I'll tell you what, anywhere you go around the world, the one arena that everybody knows is Madison Square Garden. And when you're so fortunate, as I was, to headline Madison Square Garden for all those years, the Garden gave me the kind of publicity worldwide, because for one thing, here in New York, that's where all the magazines were published, and there were as many as 10 magazines published a month, and because of headlining in the Garden, I would appear in maybe 6 and 7 on the cover of those magazines, and those magazines would go all over the world. So that when, you know, Vince McMahon Sr., when he was getting requests from other countries about me making some appearances there. Because of Madison Square Garden, I was automatically the headliner everywhere I went. All the different countries that I wrestled in, I always went as the headliner because of Madison Square Garden. So the Madison Square Garden has meant an awful lot to me, and it did so much for me. Thank you. But those 24 years, 25 years, as these guys can tell you, it take a great toll on your body. In fact, might have been even a little tougher in my day because they had those crazy boxing rings, and those things were like concrete. They had to be reinforced with steel posts underneath because fighters, they wouldn't lose their footings. And when you're getting body slammed and all these other crazy things that you go through, after time and time and time and year after year after year, you pay a price. And God knows I paid one too, because after 25 years when I retired, I was happy that that day had come, because I had spent much too many years away. And now I looked forward to being with my family, with my wife and my children and so forth. But unfortunately, I was hurting very, very bad, because anybody who knows me from my era, I had some serious injuries. And I was a guy who wouldn't even take an aspirin or any kind of a painkiller or anything like that. I just sucked it up, as the old saying goes, and I kept on going. But I reached a point where I just felt like the body couldn't continue. And it was time for me, and I had to start thinking of getting out. But there again, I was such a very lucky guy. Because with all these injuries, and I was in pain 24 hours a day, happy to be home, but suffering all the time. And then, you know, there were two gentlemen there. They've come here from Pittsburgh. These two gentlemen worked miracles. They saved I don't know how many lives with their magic, because they're so great at what they do in the medical field. And they made so much better quality of life for so many people. And when they took me on with all these things, I required over maybe 8 major surgeries. But today, I'm an old guy. I'm almost 78 years old in a couple of months. And yet, and because of these guys, these men who are so gifted, here I am, an old guy, and I still train 6 days a week, and I'm feeling great shape, and I owe it all to them for all that they were able to do for me. But let me tell you something that I'm mostly grateful and I say this from the bottom of my heart. You know, in this business, if you have the opportunity to become a so-called headliner, a promoter looks at you, perhaps he sees that there's some talent there, he sees how the fans react to you, and they give you a shot at being a headliner. Now, how do you stay on as a headliner? Well, if people come and fill those seats, you get to be a headliner again. If people don't come and fill those seats, your headlining days could be very short. I was one of the luckiest guys in the world, because when I was given that opportunity, all the fans did come out. And as they came out, they kept me as the headliner. And then again, because I headlined in the Garden so much, I was a headliner when I went to all the different countries that I wrestled to, always as a headliner. It was just so amazing, because the Garden went everywhere, and promoters would call Vince McMahon and say to him, Vince, they say, I'd like to have the service of your champion in San Francisco, in Los Angeles. And I would travel to these places, and I was fortunate everywhere because of the Garden, the publicity from the Garden, the magazines. I'd go to California, wrestle guys, greats like Ray Stevens, and we sold the place out. Kowalski, we sold out in Los Angeles. Florida, we packed them in. Atlanta, everywhere we went, because of the publicity, again, I say, from the Garden. So I want to conclude, because it's late and we'll be going here too long, but I just want to say this, that I'm very grateful for tonight, for Arnold, for the WWE, who sees me worthy of this honor, and the opportunity to have appeared in Madison Square Garden one more time. I'm very grateful for that. But most of all, But most of all, I want all the fans, whether in this country or around the world, if this gets televised everywhere, that whatever success I've had, I owe it all to you. Because if you didn't come out and support me the way you did, I would have never become anybody. So I thank you. I thank you for the support and the kindness you showed me for all these years. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you, and God bless all of you. Thank you.
Do it for your name. There's gonna be a day when you're